Hey cuties, I'm Lanikia, and you're watching What Happened on the Soap Sisters General Hospital Edition. Today is Wednesday, June 8th, 2023. On a scale of 1 to 10, honestly, it was solid. I'm going to give it a 7. Okay, let's start off with Lucy and Martin. So Lucy and Martin are talking, and, you know, he knows there's something up with her, there's something wrong, but she won't tell him. Tell him what's going on, but he knows that she's upset about something, but she won't come out and tell him, you know, it's about the marriage. He's acting weird. He's acting strange. And then around this time, Mac and Felicia come up, and Mac goes to get Felicia a drink, and Lucy tells Martin, can you get me one as well? And he tells her, you still got half your drink left. And she said, listen, go get me a drink and you bond with Mac. Because when Kevin and I were together, me, Mac, Felicia, and, you know, we were all good friends. And I want to go on couples outings and stuff. So go bond with Mac. And he's like, okay. So he goes, and while he's with Mac tells him, you know, he's talking about Lucy. They start talking about Lucy, and he was like, she's so forgiving and all this. And he said, oh, you don't know the Lucy, that if you cross her, that's not her. He said, Lucy doesn't like people to manipulate her. She doesn't like people to play her for a fool. Like, she doesn't like people to just look at her as just this little airhead. Because Lucy is not. Like, she is not just an airhead or whatever that you can just manipulate and get one over on her. We've been known this about Lucy, but Martin's about to find out because he's on to some kind of trickery. But Matt tells him, but it doesn't matter because y'all are equals. You know, y'all don't look at you don't look at her like she doesn't have any sense, or she's not business savvy and she can be easily manipulated. You don't look at her like that, so y'all good. And Martin started thinking about his conversation with ex number 3. And I said, all right, y'all. So anyways, we go over here to Felicia and Lucy. And she starts telling her that, you know, Martin's acting really weird. When I try to tell him about give him credit on the deceptor, he's like, he shuts it down immediately. And that doesn't make sense to me. It's just all types of things. You know, he gets phone calls. He doesn't tell her who he is. He won't answer the phone sometimes. And something feels off. So Felicia says, well, I could investigate, she said. And Lucy doesn't want to admit that that's what she wanted. But then Felicia was like, well, but I mean, if you don't really want me to, she said, okay, fine, Felicia, you win. Investigate him. I said, oh, well, maybe this is what Anna and Felicia is going to be doing, because they have been dropping hints that Anna is going to be working to help somebody else. So maybe it's going to be this. Maybe this storyline with Martin and everything is going to be bigger than what, you know, what we're seeing that it is. All right, guys. So moving on from then, we go over here to Brooklyn and Maxie. So she's at the deception. Brooklyn has brought lunch. And when she brings in the lunch, Maxie's just like, they're doing so well with deception. They're doing so well. They can't decept her, that they can't keep them in stock. And, you know, it's a good problem to have. And so they're happy about that and everything. So then they continue to talk about Maxie's going to buy a house. First of all, she said, Brooklyn, I thought you had the day off. But Brooklyn just told her, you know, she wanted to come on in to work. So anyways, Maxie's talking about buying her a house. And Brooklyn said, why haven't you did it already? Like, you're rolling in the dough and everything. Why haven't you done it? Because y'all know deception does very well. And she said, well, she hasn't done it because, you know, her apartment, it's where she met Nathan. And, you know, it's where they were. And it's where she and Nina planned his funeral. It's just, she has memories there. And she almost feels like she'd be leaving him behind if she left. But now, you know, she knows, you know, he'll always be in her, you know, in her heart and everything. So it's okay to move on. You know what I mean? And so Brooklyn says, I understand that. But then, Maxie gets a phone call and she has to leave the office, right? Because the distribution is having a hard time keeping up. So she goes and meets with them, and Brooklyn goes and she puts a USB drive in the computer so that she can copy the files. Okay. And she says, hey, and she says, oh, you're making this too easy for me, Maxie. And she starts copying the files. And so when Maxie comes back, Brooklyn is gone. And she calls and says, has Brooklyn made it back? Ma'am, don't start that. Has Brooklyn made it back to her office? And her assistant said, Brooklyn didn't come in today. And she said, what? She had lunch with me. She said, no, Brooklyn didn't come in. So I don't know, child. All right. So then we go from the, oh, and Maxie also told Brooklyn that she trusted her with her life. And Brooklyn was like, you shouldn't. She was like, what does that mean? And she said, well, you know, I couldn't always be trusted. You know, I always look out for me and for my best benefit. And I'm always, you know, I haven't always been trusted. She said, yeah, but that was before. And they didn't get along. She said, that was before baby Lou and all that. So everything is good. Hold on, y'all. Oh, my gosh. All right. So anyways, child. So Maxie was like, yeah, but we trust each other now and we've moved past that. I said, girl, Brooklyn telling you the truth. Don't trust me. So anyways, at the Quartermains, Scout Dante and Sam come over, and Tracy's like, what y'all doing here? Olivia and them are not here and everything. And they were like, no, we're actually come for another reason. And Drew comes in and he lets Tracy know they're there for him because they need to tell Scout about him going to prison. And they were like, haven't you read the news? I mean, heard the news? And she said, no, I've been busy. This is them to Tracy. And they tell her that Drew got 3 years. And she said, whoa. Now, even Tracy was like, that's not right. And they said, the judge is making an example. She said, but that kind of example, that's crazy. But it is what it is. So Dante ends up taking Scout out because before all this, Dante and Scout are gone. She's showing him around and everything. And so when it's Tracy, Drew, and Sam, she tells him, why don't you just roll over on Carly so that you won't have to go away from your family for this long? Like, what are you doing? What you trying to prove? And Sam says, I have to agree with Tracy. And Drew said, what? She said, well, why do you have to be the one that comes in the white knight? They're both like, Carly doesn't pay for this at all. There's no consequences for her. And Drew says, being gone would do minimum damage. Where if Carly leaves, and they said, but what about your daughter? Like, you can't. I just don't like the way they're trying to make Drew seems like he's just so good because he's taking the fall for this because it, you know, if Carly goes away, all these different people would have their lives upended. But if it's just me, it's just Scout. Like, damn. Say you don't really care about your child without saying it. I mean, because that's what I heard. Who wouldn't try to fight this and be with their child? And so Sam and Tracy don't understand it. And so him and Sam start arguing about it because Sam said, so Scout is just collateral damage? That you're cool with that? And he was like, no, I'm not cool with it, but she has y'all. Sir, just sign over your parental rights. If that's how you really feel, where you will put someone else's family and their children above your own, just sign over your rights. And you could come, you could be the uncle that comes through. Or what, you know what I mean? Cause just give it a Dante. Just let Dante be the dad, and you could just be the dad, stepdad that just comes through every now and then. Cause come on now, come on. But anyways, they're arguing, and Scout comes in, and she says, "Why are y'all fighting?" And they break down to Scout that he has to go away to prison, and Sam says that she will take Scout to see him every weekend, rain, snow, sun, whatever. She's gonna take him every weekend. I said, you better than me, because I wasn't tired of my weekends. I'm sorry. I wasn't tired of my weekends. So she could see him. I'd be like, well, you should have thought about that before you took this deal or whatever. But yeah, anyways, child, maybe I'm just hard. I don't know, but I'd be like, I got plans on some of these weekends. You can't go. But anyways, that's it with them, you guys. They're pretty much
they're done talking about it. Dun, he tells Dante, you know, thank you for, you know, all you've done, because Dante lets him know that he'll, on the low, he'll be looking out for him in prison if he runs into any trouble or anything like that, and he thanks him for that and everything. And then he says, I gotta go see Carly. Of course you do, go on. And so then we see that Brooklyn comes in and she gives the information to Tracy. Yeah. And Tracy said, oh, we didn't expect to go back that far to last fall, all the way back. And Tracy said, and Brooklyn's like, who is we? Who are you working with? And she said, mind your business. And that's pretty much it with them, y'all. So then we go over here to Carly and Jocelyn, and they are talking, right? And they're just talking about, Carly said, I know, go ahead and say I told you so. They, she said, either way, I was never going to turn Sunny in, but you can say I told you so, because now Drew has to go away and everything. And Jocelyn says, that's not our relationship. That's not what we do. And, you know, it is what it is. I hate that Drew has to go away. And then Diane comes over, right? So when Diane comes in, she tells Carly, honestly, that was the best deal. And this is the best deal you're going to get also. So they've put down their fees on how much they feel like you should pay. And so Carly opens up the folder and looks, and you can see on her face, it was going to be a lot. And I said, well, how much you got to pay? What, $3 million? And it was close. It was $5 million she has to pay. And Diane said they gave you the max amount that you have to pay. They, like, they're using them as an example. And she said, oh my God, that's my whole savings. I said, girl, I wish I did have $5 million in savings, baby. Anyways, child. So she said, oh my gosh, that's my whole savings. I mean, and Justin said, you could use my trust fund. And she said, no, I'm not going to take money from you. And then Justin said, well, what about Michael or Sonny? And Diane said, you can't do it, sis. And they were like, what? And she said, you can't get money from Sonny, because then if they see you got money from him, they'll start looking at y'all affairs together. And that ain't going to end well for neither one of you. And she said, and Michael, he managed to slip slide through this without having to face any consequences. Even if you are his mother, if they see somebody who has something to do with Aurora as well as ELQ giving up money, they're going to start looking into him and being like, well, did he know anything about it? I said, Michael Shaw did slip slide through this without having to do anything. Anyway, this child. So she said, you just going to have to get your savings up for this one. And she told her, I know it don't seem like it now, but this was the best deal. And Carla was like, girl, I'm broke. I'm going to be broke. This ain't the best deal for me. I said, they don't got payments, payment plans. Install me, please. Installment plan, please. Mm-hmm. Anyways, y'all. They so after that, Diane ends up having to leave because she has to sign the deal for the, you know, the agreement or whatever. And Carly said, I am Carly Spencer. I said, I know that's right. She said, I had to get out the mud before and I will do it again. If they hit me, I'll hit back harder. I'm going to be all right. She said, I did think I was going to get Metro Court back. But since I didn't, it's been a year. It's not coming back. She said, I'm going to give me a job. I said, where you going to work at, girl? Where are they going to have Carly working? Where are they going to have her working? I'm sure that she can't work at Aurora because they're going to say something about that. Where she go? Where are you gonna work at, girl? But anyway, she said, I'm gonna give me a job. I'm gonna get myself a job, and I'm gonna be all right. And Jocelyn's like, okay. And so then Drew comes over, and they say it's the last. It's the beginning. It's the last time they're gonna be together. I said, all right, let's move on, child. Let me see who else I gotta go to. So then we go over here to Eddie Main. So Eddie Main, Dex has brought him back or whatever. And he said, I would like it if your man didn't manhandle me. And I am leaving on the first train smoking. And Sonny said, no, you're not. And Ned said, yeah, I read up on you. You ain't tell me you and Olivia had a child. He said, that child is grown and has a family of his own. I don't want no Olivia. Like, it ain't nothing there right there. And then he said, and I saw your history, your criminal history, which gonna have me sleeping with the fish. He might not have said that, but that's what I heard. And the Sonny told him, listen, I want you to stay in town because Brooklyn and Olivia mean a lot to me. So I want you to stay in town so I will help you out with your music career. I'll do everything that I can to help you out and, you know, so that you can get your foot and just stay in town. And so Eddie, like, this is sounding pretty good. So then we go over here to Ava, right? So Ava is, Pilar told her, I don't know where Ava is. Now, I thought Ava was in on this, but mama had no clue. So she freaking out, like, where is my baby? Or whatever. And then Chase comes up, because they called the cops. And so Chase comes up, and he said, we're going to do everything we can to find her. And she says, oh my gosh. He said, maybe she just wandered off. She said, no, she did not wander off. This is, you know, it's definitely something has happened. And he was like, well, why would you say that? And she, and no, she was thinking about Austin and Mason. And then she said, well, her dad is Sonny Corinthos. So he said, let's do a missing child alert. Because he was like, yeah, you're right. Let's do a missing child alert and all that. And she said, oh, my gosh, I got to call Sonny. So Ava calls Sonny while he's talking to Eddie and Nina. And so she get him on the phone and she's like, Sonny, I'm with Pilar and Avery is missing. And he said, what? And she said, yeah, we can't find her or whatever. And so he was like, drop me the pen. I'm going to be right there. So she drops the pen and Sonny tells Nina and Eddie, I got to go. And she was like, yes, 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 I heard. So he leaves, right? So while he gone, here go Nina. Now, Nina, God dang it. Now, Nina, you stop this foolishness right now. To defend you, girl. But you know I'm not biased. So Nina wrong for this, girl. You wrong for this. Now she over here dropping hints to Eddie. I mean, yeah, if you stay here, you're gonna be playing basements and living rooms. I said, now don't act like that. It's the Savoy going around here. Like they got, he got places he could play, girl. He could play at the Metro Court, the Savoy. Like, don't do that. Don't do that. It's still New York. He could go around New York and play. And so she just like, yeah, but if you go to a bigger city and stuff, you be chasing fame, you know, but you don't want that, right? And he was like, yeah, I hear what you're saying. I said, Eddie, don't listen to this manipulator. Now, Nina, you know you my girl, but I call out my people when they're wrong. I'm not biased. You wrong for this, but I get why you doing it because you want this man out of town to cover your behind. So anyways, child. We go over here. Sonny has made it over there to where Avery went missing, right? And so he was like, Ava, what's going on? And she was like, Sonny, oh my God, I can't believe this. She was with Pilar, and Pilar comes up to him. He said, I turned my back for a second, and she was gone. And so then we see that Ava, she was about to tell Sonny. She said, Sonny, there's something you need to know. And right when she was about to tell him about the whole Austin and Mason thing, which Ava, tell the man, right when she's about to tell him, Austin comes walking through with Avery. And I said, God dang it, I don't like Austin. I do not like Austin. Now, I knew he was behind it, but I thought Ava was in on it too so they could fire Pilar. And so he comes walking with Avery, and he said, yeah, I saw her by the pond all alone. Pilar wasn't there. He's making sure to point that out. Pilar wasn't there. And I saw her. So I told her, she remembered me, you know, just when being around. So I told her, come with me or whatever, and we go find your people. And she said, I saw some balloons, and I was chasing after the balloons and everything. It was like 10 of them, Daddy. And Daddy said, look, girl, don't you do that mess no more. He said, don't ever do that. You always have to be with me, Pilar, or Mommy. Don't ever go off by yourself like that ever again. And she was like, I understand or whatever. And Pilar is like, I'm sorry. And he was like, Pilar, what? And she was like, I promise I turned my back for a second. He said, don't worry about it. Because, you know, stuff happens with kids. He was just like, don't worry about it. And so he tells Ava, I'm taking Avery home, and then once you get done with the police, you can come check on her. So Sonny and Avery go home, and she runs up to Nina like, Nina! And so and she's like, oh my gosh, we were so worried about you and all this. And then they go and they leave or whatever. And then Sonny and Eddie are talking, and Nina watching from the back. And Eddie says, well, you know, for right now, you offered me the best deal I got, so I'm gonna take you up on your offer. Baby, Nina was upset because she said, sir, I need you to leave town. What are you doing? I said, you should have offered to fund them then, girl, but don't do that. You done did. You've done enough. So then We see that, who else do we go back to Avery Nim? So after Chase leaves, he takes their statements and everything. He tells Pilar, do you want to ride home? And she's like, yes. And she tries to talk to Ava, and Ava says, we'll talk about this later or whatever. And so she leaves. And then Austin says, it was good thing I'm here. And Ava slaps the mess out of him because she knows you were behind this. Now, Austin, let me tell you something. I was liking you and Ava together, but you on some trickery. You on some foolishness. I don't trust Austin. I do not, because they made it seem like, oh, he wants to get out of the game. He wants to get out of the game. He doesn't want to do this anymore or whatever. But the stuff he doing, like, baby, what you're not going to do is come up and walk up and take my child and then stroll yourself back up just like everything is all good. See? Like, that was part of our plan to try to get Pilar fired, baby. No. I would have told Sonny right then and there what was going on. Because you're not going to do that. Mm-mm. That's what you're not going to do. But I don't know. Ava, you need to leave this man alone. You need to tell Sonny what's going on. Didn't you learn your lesson with Nicholas when you and y'all tried to hide Esme and she popped back up anyways? Tell Sonny what's going on, ma'am. You see the man, how quickly the man was able to get your child. Go ahead and tell him. And then this whole thing with Martin and Lucy and Tracy, because who feels like Tracy and Martin are in on this together? I don't know who their partners are, but I feel like they're in on this together, and I don't know, child. I don't know what's happening. What's going on? Who is this? I don't know, child. Anyways, guys, y'all tell me what you think in the comments. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you guys tomorrow for an all new episode of What Happened. Isn't the week going by fast? Or what happened on the soaps? General Hospital Edition. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.